all, welcome to John's Bomber Making. As you can see, I'm working on the Lancaster Bomber. This is the second engine. As you can see, it's only partially completed. Well, the day cells are on it, the engine's all completed. But compare it with the first engine. There we go. We get the undercarriage with it. Now, I have found a tester. Here it is. This is from one of my Agora builds. This was probably from the Zero, the Mitsubishi Zero that I built with Agora. As you can see, it's 4.5 volts. It does have a few connections, motor one, motor two, but we need motor one. Now, I'll use it on the first engine, which is completed, and it all works on 3 volts anyway, so it should work fine on 4.5 volts. Switch it on, it should light up. There we go. That's working great. Now I can't get it to stop. But it's working fantastic. Now we'll try it on the second engine, because this one gave me more problems. And I was going to leave it until I got issue 39. Okay, so plug that in. There we go. That's going. Different noise, manny. But look, it still stops. I can't make it. Yeah. Now, I don't know whether it's. I'll just pause that. Get that going again. There we go. It's funny, something around that supercharger. It does seem to be slightly misaligned, that, to be honest. Well, there we go, that is working now. Was intermittent before, but I'll do, I'll strip this down, I'll have a look at it, and I'll get back to you in a minute. Zoom in a little bit more. Now, I have stripped mine down, I've taken the nacelles off, all this is loose. So if I switch it on, it does rotate. Now, here's a supercharger. Now, it does seem to be the supercharger's interfering with it. So I'll take all this off, and I won't surprise if this is loose. I did have to do quite a bit of, there we go, filing of these holes here and here, but obviously that is interfering somehow. If I push it that way, yeah, I think what I'll do, I'll file this hole here, file on this side of the supercharger, there we go, on the left side of that, see if I can make that a little bit bigger. Okay, ready to test that again. I did file it down. I have popped it into place. It isn't glued into place at all, but the bearers are pushed into that firewall nice and tight. So let's give it another go. There we go. Running brilliant. So it does seem to, for me, it was. There we go. I can't even get it to stop me. The supercharger getting in the way. Now I'll put the nacelles on and we'll have another go. There we go, that's the nacelles back on. Let's plug it back in again and give it another test. It does go until I start squeezing it together. Let's have a see. So here we have the supercharger. There we go. And all it is running fuel into the, keep turning it fuel away a little bit until we make the hole big enough. You can see. There we go. Now we'll test this again. I'll get it all back together again and we'll give it another whirl, because we have got that screw there that we can adjust once we get this into place. Okay, let's give that another shot before we put the nacelles on. There we go. Let's see if this does anything. There we go, that stops it altogether. And if I leave it there, and I'll press in the bearers, stopped it last time. Just pressing in the sides here. Right, I'll put my nacelles on. Okay, we've got everything in place now. Yeah, the nacelles, they're fine. Yeah, everything is looking hunky dory. Let's try it. There we go. Engine's working fine now. Now you noticed before, I could press both nacelles inward and it would stop the engine. Now it's rotating, brilliant. Excellent. There we go. So for me, it was a combination of that supercharger just catching and the screw at the front just needed adjusting. But we saw that and everything is working great now. Brilliant. Check it on the other engine. Okay, let's give that another whirl. Maybe I need to adjust this one. But it is working now. There we go. Excellent. There we go. I can actually move the shaft in and out a little on this one. So I'll have to be mindful of that when we come to put the propeller on. But it's working anyway, it's fine. Now I've got the 3-volt pack. That goes first time. Excellent, that's what I always expected. So now I'll try the second engine on this 3-volt pack, see if that has any difference. Look at that, brilliant. That's working better than that one. Excellent stuff. Got that, and I can press it, mess about with it, and it still goes on working. Brilliant. So there we go, guys. That is the second engine, like I just showed you. Working great, mate. I'm just glad I actually found this when I was going through my drawers the other day. Like I said, I think this was from my Mitsubishi Zero, which is just here. It was, again, just a test PCB for doing different functions, but obviously it's it doesn't work as well as this little 3-volt pack. So it'll be interesting to see what the PCB from stage 39 is going to be. But both engines are working fine. I'll just show you the first one again. So I'm chuffed about that. I need to just super glue the supercharger now for the second engine, but I'll do that when I get the pack. Pointless doing it now. I just wanted to show everybody what problems I was having, and now we've resolved them. I'm quite confident. There we go. That one's going brilliant as well. Oops. Say it is. Nope, there we go. Excellent. I think I'll just Yeah, that's fine. Brilliant. Just have to keep my eye on these engines. Well, there we go. I do hope that helped anyway. Making the hole where the shaft goes through around the supercharger did help, and obviously the screw at the front, loosening that off, because I fully tightened it, it's not working altogether, and then it was just a matter of releasing the screw until the actual shaft started spinning, and it did. Now, when I, as you saw, when I pressed the nacelles together, it doesn't stop it from spinning. So I think it was a double factor on this, because obviously I tried the screw previously on its own, and I hadn't enlarged the hole through the supercharger. I mean, don't get me wrong, we shouldn't have to be doing this, but you know, it's part of building, isn't it? It's modelling for you. There we go. Anyway, I hope you did like that, and I hope that's helpful for anybody who's been having problems with their engines. There we go. So anyway, I'll see you soon for, well, we're on 39, 40, 41, 42. I'm not sure when they're coming, actually, but whenever they come. Anyway, thanks for tuning in and watching. Stay safe. See you soon. Bye for now.